if you don't have the budget to go learn a 2D animation tool, or you don't have the skills yet to create animation, but you want to use animations, whether it's for a YouTube channel, or you want to use it in your classroom, or for your kids, or for whatever reason, you're just fascinated with animations, but you're not there yet, this video is for you. So I don't want to get mentions on the comments to say, oh, it's not moving. We are using what we have. We're doing the Luther Van Ross here. We love the one we're with. We are taking Canva and we're using these tips to help us create animations for our kids, for our classrooms, for our YouTube channels. And we have the illusion that we are animating. This video is all about that. If you're all about that, then please join me. So to create this illusion of our animation, we're going to be doing it in 5 steps. Step number one is for you to get a very good script, whether you use ChatGPT, or whether you write it yourself, or whether you ask your kids to come up with a very good story that kids are going to love. Get a very good script that you're going to be using. Next, log in on Canva and then create a project, preferably video project. I like landscape, but whichever format of video that you want to use, select that and open a project. What I usually then do is to have a project where I'm busy creating my images and my sources and my resources and my music and all of the tools that I'm going to be using on my animation. I have a separate tab that I open to go and create that on. And the next step is where the actual project of me creating this animation, I will create it there. Once you've set up your project and it's up and running and you've renamed it, the second step is to create your scenes. So based on the storyline that you would like to follow, you decide how many scenes that you would like to create for your project. On this particular project, I want to have 6 scenes for where the girl is going through phases of going over her fear of public speaking. But the first scene, which is where I would like to introduce the character, is the intro that I want to create. So I want to create this animation intro, and I will use all of my tools in Canva to do this. So I found this video, I went to my elements, and then I searched for animation book, and then I looked for videos. Once I searched for videos, I got a lot of these videos that are animated. When you hover, it shows you how the video looks like, and you could pick any one that you want to use. I want one that zooms in and pages out, like this particular one that I found under animation book videos. It's a 7-minute intro, and when you edit and you set it as background, when you play it, it looks like this. And then it opens up the page. So because this is my intro to the animation, the second page, I want to introduce Lebo, and I want to add nice colors at the background. So you can go and find beautiful images like the gray smoke spray that you could use. So based on the kind of animation that you want, you can go find elements that would suit what you want to create. So I had an overlay haze smoke, and then I have little stars that are sparkling on there. And once I've set up my first page of her zooming in, I add her picture. And this is the trick with you learning animation and you're not there, a full-on 2D animator. Use the animations that Canva has for your advantage. That's the whole point of this video. So I found the succession animation that zooms out. It gives that feeling that you're watching something that is moving. She's not necessarily walking or whatever, but it gives you that, or it gives the viewer the feeling that they are watching an animation. And then I split the page into 2, and then I add the name of the animation, which is Lebo's Inspiring Stories. And then I found this animating bobbing tool that I used. So where did I find this bobbing tool? On my elements, and I used that. So when you play the introduction, it looks like this. Very cool. So this is my first scene, done and dusted. Scene number two, I'm gonna click and add a page. What do I want to do on scene two? I want to introduce you to Lebo. So we're going to look for a setting on Canva. We're gonna go to our elements and we're gonna look for a setting where we could introduce the Lebo character. As we create these different scenes, what I want you to do when you're creating them, make sure that you pick things that you are able to manipulate and make move. For example, when you're creating a lounge, find a lounge that you could add fire to, because there is animated fire that you could use. When you are creating a classroom, maybe add a clock that moves so that it shows an animation. The other thing that we're going to be doing is to have her animated when she speaks, and have her animated when she blinks, and we have a truck move. So with the tips and tricks that you're using to have the illusion that you are 2D animating, that is the trick. It is to, when you're creating your scenes, make sure that your scenes have places where you can move the character, where the truck can move, where fire can be burning, where somebody can be speaking, and so on and so forth. So because it took me like 2 hours to create these scenes, I'm not going to show you that, because you have seen different videos that I've done on YouTube, and I will link all of these videos in the description below so that you have them to guide you of where to find things, how to animate the mouth, how to animate eyelids, and so on. I would link them in the description below. The reason why this video was created is to make sure that we are hacking animation while we are learning these other tools that we, at the moment, some of us cannot afford. We have recorded all of our scenes and we are happy. Now we're going to jump into step number 3, which is adding animations and effects. So you're going to play your slides, and where you see that you want to add animation and effects, that's where you need to jump in. So with the introduction of our scene, I've added an animation on Lebo. So how you add animation is you select whatever you want to add animation on, and you click where it says animation. I've already added slick. So where you select animation, you then scroll down and you pick any animation that you would like to use, and then your animation is added. When you want to add transition, when you hover in between pages, you can click where it says add transitions, and then you have different transitions that you could add. One of the nicest and easiest animations that I use on my animations is the match and move, because it usually matches the previous slide with the next slide. So you pick the animation that you want to use, and you set the duration, and you would do that with all of your slides by adding your animations and transitions. The most animations that you need to add to your slides to take you to the next level with your animations is to make sure that your slide moves a bit. So with the fire scene that we've added, we are going to go to our elements and we're going to look for an animated fire and then add it to our scene. Scroll and find the animated flame and then add it to your scene. You can always go to your settings and scroll down and look for animated. That way you get to view animated elements that you could use. So you click on it once and then you reduce the size. Remember, we want to have the scene animated, something on the scene. So with the fire, it's animated, and we're going to add our audio on our next step. But for now, we're just adding animation on the scene. And with our school scene, select the image and click on edit image. And then we want to use the magic grab tool for this one. And we can grab the bus. We select the bus and we click on grab. Then I'm going to select the bus and I'm going to click on animate. And I'm going to click on create an animation. And then I'm going to drag my bus so that it moves ever so slowly. And I'm going to click on done. And I'm going to go to my elements and I'm going to search for birds. I'm going to click on create an animation. And I'm going to have my bird fly a bit. And this is what you would do for all of your scenes. If you have to have the person's eyes move, you would animate their eyes. If you had to have their mouth talk and you create that illusion, you would do that. If you want these videos, I have created them and I've linked all of them for you in the description below so that they guide you. Otherwise, this video is going to be 2 hours long. So the trick here is have something animated on your slide that will create the illusion of animation. We're going to get to the stage where we move arms and we move legs, but we're not there yet. For now, we are happy if the person's mouth move and you add your audio so that they talk through whatever it is that you want them to talk through. After you've animated all of your slides and you are happy that there's movement somewhere on your slides, you're ready to jump to step number 4 and number 5, which is adding audio on step number 4 if you want to. And then step number 5, you review and then you export your video. This is what I use for my animation. Canva has various apps that you could use to record audio and AI voices. One of the tools that I use is called AIVoo.com. You get a certain amount of credit on your account and characters, and then once you exceed that, you are then asked to go buy more. But this tool is available, and there's plenty other apps that are available on Canva that you can use to record the audio and the voices. The other tool that I use that's also available for free and paid is called narakit.com, and I use various voices here and I use it for my animation. The other tool that I use is 11labs.io, and you can record, download. Again, this it's available for free and for paid, but yeah, there's also limits. When it comes to music, I also use Canva. So with my audio on Canva, if I go and I search for a, let's call it a happy song or whatever song, and you enter and you go to your audio, there would be different kinds of songs or sound effects or whatever kind that you want. Most of these on Canva are for pro. There are free that you could find that you could use on your videos. Take note, if you do use it and you add it like I have done on my animation, Canva is going to ask you to make sure that you have linked your Canva account to social media accounts. Because if you haven't, you might get copyright or you might get not to monetize your video or your animation that you've created. So you need to connect to your social accounts if you're using the Canva's audio, and then you won't have an issue because then they're talking to each other. The other free place that I use, especially for sounds, is freesound.org. Once you have this and you've registered, you're able to use the free sound, like it says, it is free. And for music, I use mixkit.co. So far, I haven't had issues with the sound effects as well as music and videos that I found here that I use for my videos on YouTube and other social media platforms. You are now going to play your animation and you're going to check if it's animating the way that you want. And you're going to review your work. And you're gonna twist and tag and make sure that everything is seamless and you're happy with that. Once you've played it and you're happy and you're good to go, you're gonna go to share and you're going to go to download and you're going to select an MP4 video, and then you're going to make sure that it's connected to your social media, and then you download the file. If you want this template that I've created, I'm going to also link it in the description below for free. Take note that there is tools that are here or elements that are here that are paid for. You're more than welcome to trial it for 30 days because I do have a 30-day free option that you can use for Canva Pro and test it out and see if it's something that you might enjoy. Watch the full video and let me know in the comments below your thoughts.
Meet Lebo, a young girl afraid of public speaking. She has a very important speech to make in front of the whole school and she's freaking out.
Two things you must always remember with public speaking. Number one, practice, practice and practice some more. Number two, remember to always focus on your message, not your fear.
I got this, I can do this. In conclusion, teachers are retiring, robotics and artificial intelligence is the future. Lely conquered her fear and inspired others. You can too.
You can now go watch the next video that's going to help you animate, like blinking or how to make mouths move. Have fun with it. Please let me know in the comments below if this has added value. I had lots of fun with this video. I will see you with our next video.